everybody. Welcome to episode 49 of the BrownieKnits podcast. I'm your host, Gina, aka BrownieKnits, and this is my little sidekick, Kennedy, aka Kiki. I thought I'd podcast from the backyard today. It is October, what is today? The 12th, and it's still a little bit unseasonably warm here. Usually has dropped a little bit by now, but that's okay. So I thought I'd take advantage of being able to be outside. And I hope you guys are all doing well and that you've been having some yarny fun over the last few weeks. I've been busy here doing some fun things. So most of what I've been working on is just for fun and just for me or someone in my household. So it's been kind of fun. Anyway, this is the second year anniversary of the podcast. So I cannot believe how fast that went by. And thank you to everybody, whether you were in on it from the beginning or you're just joining us. Thank you so much for watching and participating in the Ravelry BrownieKnits board and everything that, all the messages and everything. I really love getting to speak with all of you. So, all right. So I have some lovely things to share today and talk about. So I hope you have some knitting or crochet with you. And here we go. So first up, I got to participate in a swap with, a one-on-one swap with, I believe you pronounce your name, Elo. And she is, I believe she's from Estonia, but now lives in Norway. And so I sent her some yarns that she might not be able to get very easily in Norway, and she sent me some that I can't get very easily here in the US. So I thought I'd share what she sent over. It was a lovely package, and one of the things in the package was this little sheepy journal. It's so cute. It has the little sheep face on the front, and then the inside has like little the swirlies and stuff of the sheep on the pages. Isn't that cute? So now that I've shown it here, I can start writing into it. I think I might keep it in my purse and use it as a little purse journal. So I just thought it was adorable. And then she sent me some lovely yarns. So this is a lace weight yarn, and the red is absolutely gorgeous. It's 70% baby alpaca and 30% mulberry silk, and it's lace drops. And let's see, it has, does it say 875 yards? I don't like red or anything. It matches perfectly. So I just think that's beautiful. So I have to find the right lace weight project for that. And then she sent these two skeins. And these are from a Norwegian dyer. And I laughed so hard because I opened up the package and I held them up and my husband said, "Oh, that looks like autumn." And that's the name of it, autumn. So you nailed that perfectly. Aren't they gorgeous? They, on the tag, 75% wool, 25% nylon. And then it's 205 meters in each skein. And I'm not sure if it's a fingering weight or maybe a sport weight. Actually, I think it is a fingering. Regardless, I'm going to use it to make socks. Don't those look like the perfect fall colors, first pair of fall socks? So just gorgeous. I really loved that. And she included some tees that are gone now. but then she made me this little progress keeper with my name on it, and it's so cute. And I just thought it was so thoughtful. So you can see there, a little progress keeper. How fun is that? And she just used yarn. So she just threaded yarn through the beads. And this actually inspired me, and I thought, you know, I have all these beads upstairs, and so I should sit down and see what I need to make some progress keepers. So I did that and I had everything I needed except for crimping beads and some wire, because I wanted to do like the smooth wire progress keepers and stitch markers. So I did that and sat down one day and made a bunch, and I just had so much fun. And yeah, I think I'll be making more of those in the future. It was just super easy to do, and it's just fun to do a craft other than the one that you do every day, because I got so lost in it, in fact, that I forgot to make lunch that day for my hubby. Not that I always make lunch for him. I don't want to make it sound like that. We actually have split duties pretty well, but he works from home, so sometimes he has meetings through lunch, and on those days I'll make his lunch and take it up to him, and I totally spaced it. Poor guy. An hour later he comes down and I was still making beads, or still making progress keepers. So anyway, thank you so much, Ayla, for participating in the swap package with me. I really appreciate it, and it was a lot of fun, and I hope that you enjoyed the yarns that you received. So next up, I thought I'd show some of my projects that I've been working on lately. And are you going to stay sitting there? Are you going to be a good little girl? Oh, before I do that. So if you are a longtime podcast viewer, you know that every year I make little journals for myself that are just, I just cover the notebooks and like magazines and photos and things like that. And then use that all year to make notes, to make podcast notes, notes while I'm watching other people's podcasts, because we all know there is nothing more enabling to buy yarn than watching somebody's podcast. And just, I use it for kind of everything. Well, it is October 12th, like I said, or 13th. I'm losing my days, 12th, I think. And I've already used up my full book for 2016. And really, in all honesty, had used it all up by the end of September. So I was like, well, I guess I could go ahead and make another one and use it into next year, but that just means I'm going to run out in like June of next year or something. And then I saw these planners and I thought, yeah, I'm going to get one of those. So Aunt Kiki wants down. We'll put her down. We're outside. So she loves to run around her backyard. So she's going to do that. But anyway, so I went out and purchased this planner. And this is one of the happy planners, and it comes with, let's see, I'll show you a month that doesn't have too many personal things. So I haven't written in too much on January yet, so I'll show that. But, so it has the calendars by month, and then it has, within that, days. So you can write on each day, and then you can add in like notes pages that they sell separately to make, you know, notes of whatever you want to do. And then they have little things like these little, they remind me of Trapper Keeper folders. Do you guys remember Trapper Keepers, or is that just a US thing? So back in the 80s and 90s, at least, I don't know, might have been beyond, but 80s and 90s is when I was had a Trapper Keeper. And anyway, so it has all of that stuff in there. And then I am sure that a lot of you do these things already, so I'm probably just preaching to the choir. But then you can buy stickers to kind of jazz it up. So I'm a huge basketball fan, which you also know and are probably sick of me talking about college basketball. Big difference. But anyway, so on all the IU games, I have my little basketball stickers. And if you go on Etsy, you can find so many people who make and sell the stickers, really for pretty reasonably priced. And then there are stickers that, of course, the Happy Planner people sell. So you can get fun things for like holiday stickers, which I've used most of the fall ones and things. And birthday stickers and little stars when you've completed a project or whatever. But I found, and this person is on Etsy, and she's symposipress.etsy.com. I found these little knitting ones. So you have little like cast on, and then your progress, and like a little finish sticker. So that way you can track your little projects in your happy planner. Isn't that fun? So I had to get a couple of those. And it does say, I don't know if you can see it, it's really light, but it does have a percentage there. So those were kind of fun, and she included like little extras. I thought the little nail polish was cute. So anyway, so I spent a good chunk of time one day making progress and progress keepers and stitch markers with beads, and then one day putting this together and having fun with that. And the thing that I like about it too is that the pages, here I'll take one out so you can see it. The pages are all, it's not really like a three-hole punch, it's more, can you see that? And they do sell the little punch, so that if you wanted to buy the punch and make your own pages of things that you've printed out or whatever and put in, you could. And at first I thought, well, I won't do that. And then I thought, for 2017, I've been noodling about what I want to do for my year project. And I've decided that I have so much sock yarn, so I'm going to really, really try hard to knit 2 pairs of socks a month and use up some of that sock yarn and continue to buy more sock yarn. But also, I want to not just make 24 pairs of vanilla socks. Maybe I'll make 12 pairs of vanilla and 24 of other things, or I'll switch up, you know, heels and toes and things like that. And those things I could print and then punch and put in to my binder and have a sock section, because this is pretty much always with me. So that's kind of where I'm thinking. So, and they do have these little, the things on the edge, I don't even know what you call them. Anyway, they have expander ones so that you can get bigger. And then if you wanted more of a journal size that you could keep in your purse, they do have smaller ones too. So anyway, I thought it was fun and a little bit different than what I've done the last couple years. So I enjoyed it. I'm having fun with it. But I just closed myself because I have, of course, my podcast notes are in here as well. So I just closed my podcast notes. Need to open that back up. All right, so let's talk about what I've been knitting on. So in my little fall bird leg bags bag, I have been knitting these socks. Now, I am a cuff down sock knitter. So I thought, okay, in my effort to break out of my sock shell, right, I should do some toe up ones. And so I used Judy's Magic Cast On for my toe up cast on. And then see this square toe here? It's called Square Toes. And it is, let me make sure I tell you correctly, it's by Janel Rockwell. And it's a free pattern in Ravelry. And if you download the pattern, there's actually 2 sets of instructions in the pattern. And the toe that I have here is the first one. So I followed her instructions until I got 64 stitches total. So 32 stitches on each needle because I did magic loop. And then I just knitted in stockinette until I was 3 inches from the end of my foot on the heel side. And at that point, I was like, okay, what heel am I going to do? And I sort of wanted to do one with a gusset since this was my first toe up sock, because when I did cuff down socks for the first time, I learned on a gusset. So that's what I wanted to do. I knew I could just throw in a fishless lips kiss heel or a garter stitch heel and that would be fine. But I wanted to do one with a gusset. So I picked this one because it looked very interesting to me. And this heel is called Toe Up Socks with a Difference by Wendy D. Johnson. And it is also a free Ravelry download. Now, this one's unique because the gusset is on the bottom of the foot. Usually it's, you know, over here on the side. This one is on the bottom of the foot. Isn't that interesting? And I was really worried that I might feel the increases when I wore it, but I don't at all. And I'm a pretty picky person about that, so. But anyway, I thought that was really interesting. And then you do a little heel turn that's very, very short, I thought. But it worked perfectly. And then you have like a little slip stitch section here that sits at the back of your heel on your leg. I'm trying to think if there are any. I did have to manipulate the pattern a little bit when I picked it up here to decrease the hole that was there, because there wasn't like a pick it up in the corner or anything. So I sort of followed the instructions from the Hermione's Everyday pattern to get rid of your heel or your hole at where your sock meets back up and you start working in the round again. So that was really fun. And then I just knitted and stockinette until I was about an inch and a half from my desired depth of the leg. And I chose to do a 1x1 rib because I thought it sort of mimicked the back of my heel leg area. And I bound off, and I bound off too tightly and it wouldn't go around my foot. And so I took the bind off out, and I did a Judy's Surprisingly Stretchy bind off. And that, I have the book Cast On Bind Off, and that, the instructions for that cast off, or that bind off, sorry, are in there. And you can see it really is super stretchy and it fits incredibly well. So there you go. So that's fun. And the second sock is already on the needle, so I've already done my toes, so I should be able to finish those up hopefully this weekend. We went to see a girl on the train, the girl on the train, so I knitted my foot while we were in that movie. All I'll say about the movie is read the book instead, so that's all I'll say. Love the book. And speaking of books, the other thing that I've been doing, spending a lot of my time doing, is listening to audiobooks. And I do a fair amount of listening through Audible. And one of my friends, Carol, hi Carol, told me about her library having these playaways. So I went and asked, and my library has them too. So I thought I'd share here in case your library has them and you didn't know about it. So they're just these little devices, and then they're in the audiobook section, because I don't have a cassette player or a DVD player anymore. So I can't listen to all those audiobooks that they have. But these little playaways, they come like this, and in like a little case that I don't have down here with me. And they're battery operated, and my library always includes like an extra battery in the thing. You just plug in your headphones to the top, and you can listen away. So it's much easier to get through this one. Most of the books that I've been listening to are around 10 to 12 hours long. This Donna Tartt novel is like 32 or 35 or something like that. It's really super long. So I can just knit away on my projects while I'm listening to my books. So the other thing that I'm thinking in 2017 that I'm gonna be doing a lot of is reading via audiobooks more. So if you have any recommendations, let me know. All right, then this other knitting project. So back in May of this year, my husband took me up to Simply Socks, and I had a couple nights before, I had noticed this pattern by Stephen West of WestKnits, and I love making afghans and blankets, and this Briochevron blanket by Stephen West I had seen online, and I think I also noticed it in a booklet that in a festival that I had gone to, and I just fell in love and got obsessed. And so while we were up at Simply Socks, I bought the yarn. Well, he bought the yarn for me for my birthday to make one. And I have been obsessively working on it since I got a lot of my work, knitting and stuff wrapped up, I've been obsessively working on this. Look at it. Oh my gosh, the gorgeousness. So this is the right side, the public side, that the way that you do the brioche, every row you work twice. So you work across the row with the main color first and then with the contrast color, and then you do the back side, main color and contrast. And it's obviously in a chevron pattern, but the way it ends up working, one side focuses more on, ends up showing more the main color, and one shows the contrasting color. So here's the back side of the work. And it's so much fun! And you change like every 3 to 10 rows, you change a color, and you'd never change the main color and contrasting color at the same time. So it's always staggered between those two. Sorry, I keep hitting the table and the tripod camera shakes then. But on my front side, I'm using a lot of Hedgehog DK Merino speckle yarns. So for instance, this one down here with all the purple is Birthday Cake. And then on the back side, I'm using a lot of Cascade, their DK effects yarn. And this is their, the brighter yellow one of that. So you can kind of see how that yellow pops through a little bit and how the purple pops through a little bit. And it's just been so much fun. I will say when I first started it, I felt like I was gonna pull my hair out, and then I made a mistake and I couldn't get it corrected without taking the thing out. So I did restart it after I had had it started around my birthday. I did last week restart it, and then I've just been zipping along. So a couple notes, if you're gonna work on this project, I highly recommend putting stitch markers in between your repeats. It is a paid for pattern, so I'm not going to get too specific, but when he has you pick up stitches along here, remember that you still have your 3 stitches from your I-cord before. So you have, you know, you have to take those into account, that so it's in addition to what he has you pick up. And then the other thing I would say is there's a point where you make 3 stitches out of 1 stitch. And then on the subsequent row, if you're doing the brioche pattern, you'll understand why this was confusing. Because if I just say it, it's gonna be like, well, of course. But on the subsequent row, you do treat those 3 stitches like 3 separate stitches. So all the knitters out there are like, well, why wouldn't you treat 3 stitches as 3 separate stitches? But if you're doing this pattern and you start to do it, you'll be like, wait, and you'll understand. So anyway, those would be my tips and tricks. And I almost have all the yarns in here that I bought for it almost once. I think I have 4 more to add in. And then, you know, I'm just having fun playing with different color combinations too. So I'm trying not to be afraid of it. And I will admit that this green, when I first put it on there, I was like, ah! But I am liking it more and more, and I think it'll blend right in. So anyway, that's a really fun project. And I got this huge bag thinking I'd be able to keep my Afghan projects in it. Well, it grew way faster than I thought it was going to. And this is a pretty wide Afghan. It has just under 300 stitches. And it's on a size 8 needle. So it really is growing quickly on me. But that's okay. Maybe I'll actually get it done this year. Those are the things that I've been working on. And when I haven't been working on those, I've been obsessing about what I want to cast on. So I'm definitely going to be working on a few new projects by the time that the next episode comes out. And one of those projects is what I mentioned in Knitspiration last episode. And that's the Fox Crossing pattern by Owlcat Designs. And this is a paid for pattern, so I'm not going to show more than just this little section. But I ended up ordering my yarn for it, and I went with, uses a sport weight. So I went with Lorna's Laces sport weight in these colors. And this is showing up on screen, and anytime I try to take a photo of it, Ooh, we got some sun rays coming down here. It is actually much more brilliant in person. So I'm hoping it's not too bright, but I did hold it up to myself in the mirror today and I liked it. So it's a little more, it's very turquoise, which is a good thing, but I was thinking it was going to be a little more blue, but that's okay. I think it looks good. And my little foxes will be this reddish orange, and they'll be outlined by this cream and chocolate. So isn't that pretty? Woo, can't wait. So I'm going to swatch for that and get that started. And then I'm also going to swatch two projects for my hubby that I'm going to get started as well. So you have to tune in next episode to see if I got that done and what they are. But in the meantime, we have some giveaways to talk about. So first up, I'm going to draw for the winner of the every other month giveaway for the 2016 Stash Down knit along / crochet along that we've been having in the group, the Brownie Knits group in Ravelry. So all year long, we've been knitting down yarn from our stash. And then every other month, I draw a winner from all of the posts there to do a giveaway. And I will freely admit that this go around in my podcast, I didn't have anything that was already yarn from my stash at the beginning of this year. So I was a bad girl there. But I do have something on the needles that is from my stash. So I am using up about almost 600 yards, but it is a Christmas gift for somebody who watches the podcast, so they cannot see it. But anyway, so the winner this time around is going to receive this skein of Knit Pick Stroll Fingering in the Coffee Shop colorway. And through random draw, the winner is number 724. And that is Golfboyzmom, and that is, I believe you would pronounce her name, Lorene, from Connecticut, and she showed her doodler shawl, and it was so pretty, so I thought I would show it to you guys here, and she, isn't that beautiful, and it looks great on her. Good job. So, boy. That project used, I made that, and that uses some major yardage. So if you're looking for a stash buster project, you could check that one out. But anyway, get in touch with me, and I will get this mailed out to you so that you can make some lovely something. I would make socks. It's so lovely. But you can make whatever you want because it's yours. Now, so we have, since I do a giveaway for that group, for that thread every other month, we have one more to go. So the winner will be announced in December for this. And this person will win this lovely skein of yarn from the Yarn Enabler. And Amanda is the Yarn Enabler, and she has a shop, yarnenabler.etsy.com, if you're looking to get some lovely yarns. And this is like lovely pinks and creams and purples, blues. Yeah. Kind of matches my flowers here. So do you guys ever take your impatiens in over the winter? Usually I pot some in the spring, and by the time we hit the heavy heat of August, they've been neglected enough that they're just, you know, there's no question they're dead by the time that we hit October. But this year, they are still crazy. So I have mums on my front porch, and I have all of my spring and summer potted plants on my back deck. And I'm thinking maybe that I might bring it in for the winter and try to save myself starting from scratch next year. But I don't know if that's a thing. Is that a thing? Let me know what you think. So anyway, you can participate in knitting some stash down, posting that thread, and then we'll draw in December for this skein of yarn. And then the other giveaway that we have going on in the group right now, and I will draw for this on my next podcast episode. I apologize if I said I was going to draw this time, but I'm actually going to draw on the next one to give more people a chance. And that way it's closer to Halloween too. So And this is a book written by a friend of mine who I worked with for many, many years in publishing, and he is now a full-time author. And so he donated this copy of his book, South Austin Vampire. And it's the author is Russ Hall. And I thought since it was around Halloween and it was vampire-ish that I'd pair it with this lovely fingering weight yarn from Swan's Island. And the color is just purple. No, just purple. but anyway, so you can check it out. And Russ does have, I'm not sure that it's this one. I think it's one at maybe Texas Gone to Hell, I think is one of his books that is an audiobook available in Audible. So if you're looking for something to try out there, and he's a great guy. And somebody asked, does he live in Austin? Does the author live in Austin? He does indeed live close to Austin. I think he's about an hour out. So yeah. All right. So, and how you can register for that prize is go up to the thread for that in the Brownie Knits Ravelry group and let me know what your favorite fall activity is or favorite fall tradition is. And it's been really fun to read through that and see how people celebrate autumn in the different parts of the world. And, you know, if you're going into spring right now, you can let us know what your favorite spring tradition is. So, there's a dog in my neighborhood going nuts. I think that's everything except for knitspiration. So what do we have for knitspiration this time, huh? Well, so the first thing that I have, and you know, I wonder, yes, I do have two. So we have one knitspiration and one crochet inspiration. And the first one for knit is, and I mentioned that I was looking first at sock patterns, and I saw Bryony Bears, so Kay Jones of the Bakery Bears podcast. She had posted a photo of one of her socks in progress on Instagram recently, and she was using her Three Chimneys pattern. And so I went and checked out the Three Chimneys pattern. Here you go. And I'm going to get this pattern at some point, and it will go into my happy planner, and it'll be a pair of socks that I make. They look enjoyable to me, to wear and to knit. And then I have long been a follower and lover of Lucy from Attic 24's work. And I knew that she had this cozy striped blanket that came out. And then all this, just recently in my Instagram feed, people are making it a lot and it kept coming up. And I really wanted to make one. And I kept taking, a lot of times if I see something on Instagram that I want to remember for later on, I'll snap a photo on my phone. And then I'll look up later what the pattern is. And it happened like five times that I, from five different people, snapped this photo. And so I definitely think this is a blanket that is appealing to me. And it's her cozy stripe blanket. And if you have followed Lucy at all, she releases her patterns for free on her blog, on her Attic 24 blog. Somebody saw a squirrel. and then you can go there and get her tutorials and stuff. So, but I think what I'm going to do, so I recently finished using up my fingering weight yarns, leftover from projects on a scrap gan. And I think what I'm going to do is use DK and worsted, light worsted leftovers. I have a huge basket of that. And I think I'm going to use that and make a cozy stripe. And maybe what I'll do is, you know, all the blues will be grouped together and then all the reds will be grouped together, that kind of thing. So I think that will be, as Hannah of the Sheep's Alley podcast says, that will be an eternity project. I love that term, Hannah. So so this will be an eternity project for me going forward at some point. Not sure when I'll start it, but I think it's a must make. And she does wonderful patterns. If you are a crocheter and you have not heard of her, check her out. All right, I think that's everything. What's been going on in life? Not much. Not much. Here's why, not much. We had to have a new roof put on the house. So yeah, you know, house poor. So the roof is on and we are settled in for any snow and such that we're gonna get this winter. So funny, like before we got the roof put on, we were a little bit worried about having leaks. So not that we saw any, but we were just concerned because it didn't look too great when we looked at the roof. And every time it would rain, we would get all anxious and go around and try to hear something was coming in. And since we've had the roof put on, it has not rained a drop. So that's supposed to change tonight. We'll see. But anyway, I thought that was kind of funny. So yeah. But by the time I talk to you the next time, I will have ventured out to the pumpkin patch, which is my favorite fall activity. So I'll try to take some photos of that to share along with you. And we're also trying to plan a little outing to the haunted hayride, which I'll tell you more about in the next episode. So I hope you guys are having a great time wherever you are, and jump up onto the Brownie Knits board, comment on the thread for this episode. Let me know how you're doing, what you're working on. All right. Happy knitting and crocheting. Bye-bye.